Now, GMA on call, you know about that little blue pill, but what about the little pink pill? Well, next month, the FDA could endorse a drug that's being called female Viagra because it's meant to give women's sex lives a boost. Our medical contributor, Dr. Marie Savard, is here to tell us all about it. So do tell us about this, Marie.
Well, Robin, let's start with Viagra. Viagra works by relaxing the blood vessels, increasing the blood flow, and increases a man's chances of being able to have sex, mm-hmm. his ability to have sex. Mm-hmm. On the other hand, this new drug, it's called flibanserin. Not approved yet, it's being looked at in the next few weeks. But what this does, it affects a woman's brain. It affects her brain chemistry, and according to the studies, increases her sexual desire or interest in sex.
So it's a brain with the woman, with the man, it's a physical
thing, the blood flow, yes.
That it helps there. Do you think this is going to be approved?
I don't know, because, well, let's, what are the issues? In this study, they actually just looked at women who have a condition that some people think doesn't even exist, something called hypoactive sexual desire disorder. Mm-hmm. And actually, I think there are a number of women out there, it's estimated around 10% of women, who really have a problem with libido, and it bothers them. That means they don't have a physical condition, they don't have hormone-related issues or depression, and they studied those women. And they did find that it actually increased their sexual desire.
Right, from 2.7 to 4.5 per month. That was the difference that we saw with the study.
That's right. Now, does that sound like much? I read it, I'm thinking, two more episodes a month, does that matter? The truth is, for some women, it does matter.
Sure.
And I don't think that we can kind of take that point lightly. These were women that were in long-term relationships. They felt there was a response to this drug. But I worry that no simple pill is going to work. And first mm-hmm. of all, we don't know the long-term effects. It takes 4 weeks to work, so it's not an aphrodisiac, let's say.
Right.
And it also took, they only studied for up to 6 months. So I think we need to sort of stay tuned on this drug. Maybe for some a small percentage of mm-hmm. women, this might make sense.
And also, this study was dealing with women that were premenopausal, before menopause, not post.
That's right. In fact, there are a number of conditions that women go through as we get older
right.
that can influence our sex lives. I mean, the truth is, we're pretty complicated, and there are a lot of factors. So let's start with just hormones, for example. As women go through menopause, or if they have surgery, if their ovaries are removed, they lose that hormone of desire, testosterone, which goes down. Mm-hmm. And there is no FDA-approved drug for women, that testosterone hormone. The second thing is depression, twice as more common in women. Anxiety and stress, just normal life stresses, I think is a big factor. And if you think about it, whether it's our children, our own partner issues, or our parents, and medications, a big one for high blood pressure medicines, antidepressants, interestingly enough, because this was originally studied as
one.
Yeah,
I think people find that surprising, because this was originally studied to be an antidepressant, and then they found this side effect.
Lo and behold, because most antidepressants actually, and it didn't work for depression, but most of them blunt your libido. And then the other pill is birth control pills. Believe it or not, for some women, mm-hmm. can lower that testosterone level and impair their sex drive somewhat.
All right, but you didn't answer. Do you think it's going to be approved?
I don't know. I'm going to say I usually have a strong feeling
right,
about something.
I know you do.
I'm going to say I hope not yet. I think we're not ready for it. I think we need longer studies, and I don't want women to get the message that there's a simple pill that's going to fix it all. I think we need to have a conversation. I'm so excited about the fact that we're talking about sex drive in women, but I don't think the answer is just a simple pill.
I was going to say this is a great thing about it, because normally we would not have had this conversation, and it is one that needs to be had, don't you think?
Yes, it is. It affects every woman in one way or another, mm-hmm. and it's a very personal issue as
it
well.
It is. All right. Thanks for discussing it with us, Marie. We'll keep an eye on this. We appreciate it very much. And you can find out more about this drug at our website, abcnews.com.